Let us take a few more questions in continuation with the previous exercise. It starts from question 29. Which of the following statement about gravitational force is not correct? They are asking not correct. So gravitational force is dependent upon mass and it is experienced by all bodies in the universe. That's correct. Dominant force between celestial bodies, this is also correct. It is negligible force of atoms. It is because within the atom there are very strong electrostatic force and as well as the nuclear forces, and gravitational force is very small in case of atoms. This is also correct. It is same for all pairs of bodies in our universe. This, in my opinion, is not correct. So option is this D, because how can it be same? It depends upon the distance, it depends upon their mass, all these things. Let's check the other question, 30. Whether an object will float or sink in a liquid will depend upon. So it depends upon their densities basically. So the option C, in my opinion, is correct option. Difference in the densities of the two objects, of between the object and the liquid, that will be the correct option for it. It does not depend upon mass. Then question 31, let's check. Which of the following device is non-ohmic? Non-ohmic means which does not depend or which does not exhibit Ohm's law. So semiconductor devices mainly, they do not obey Ohm's law. You do not have a potential difference versus current graph to be a straight line. Which one of the following is the natural phenomena based on which a simple periscope works? Periscope, basically there are two plane mirrors. They are facing each other and in a vertical column they are fitted at 45 degrees. So it is only based on reflection. So in question 32, I will go for the reflection of light. The first option is correct. Which of the following frequency range is sensitive to human ear? So human ear, you know that 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz is the correct answer to this. Then question 34, let us see. A ball balanced in a vertical rod is an example of. A ball is likely to fall down. It is there. It is not falling down, but a slight push, a slight disturbance will make it fall down. It is unstable equilibrium. Which of the following statement about a fluid at rest in a cup is correct? Okay, let's check. Pressure is same at all the points in a fluid. Absolutely wrong. Pressure is exerted on the wall. This is correct. Pressure exists everywhere in the fluid. That is also correct. So second and third option is correct. Which option do you see? B, option B. Second and third, they are correct. In question 35, option B I am taking. Then further, it is asked in question 36, which one of the devices is used to measure atmospheric pressure? Okay, atmospheric pressure is barometer. Then which of one of the following is an example of the force of gravity of the earth acting on a vibrating pendulum bob? So for a pendulum bob, the mg or a component of mg, you already know that it acts as a restoring force which helps it in oscillation. Which one of the following statements about the refractive index of a material medium with respect to air is correct? Let's check question 38. They are asking about the refractive index. Okay, let's see the option. It can be either positive or negative. No, till now I won't be agreeing to that. Question 38, just check. Can have zero value? No, it is unity for all materials. How can it be one for all? It is always greater than one. So the best option is 38D option. It is always greater than one. Let me give you a little information that there are certain developments of materials which are not naturally occurring, of course, but they have been artificially made and they exhibit negative refractive index. And these materials are called metamaterials. They exhibit negative refractive index. But we should not use this option first, because refractive index is positive for general material medium. So I go for option D in this particular question 38. Question 39. Which one of the following statements about magnetic field lines is not correct? So, okay, we need to be careful. They are asking about incorrect option. Let me read. They can emanate from a point. Yeah, from a point they can come out. they do not cross each other. This is correct. Field lines between two poles cannot be precisely straight line at the ends. They are at straight lines at the ends. There are no field lines within a bar magnet. Yeah, this is wrong. In a bar magnet, there are field lines. So I will go for option D because this is wrong. 40. Two convex lenses with power 2 diopter are kept in contact with each other. The focal length of the combined lens system will be C. Power is this. You know that 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. So power P will be equal to how much? Power P1 plus P2. So here they have given the powers as 2 diopter. So the combined power will be how much? 4 diopter. Now focal length they wanted. Focal length is equal to 1 by power. So 1 by 4 in meters, of course. And 1 by 4 will be how much? 1 by 4 will be equal to 0.25 meters. So I will go for 0.25 meters. Question 40. 41. A body has a free fall from a height of 20 meters. After falling through a distance of 5 meters, the body will be. So if it is falling 5 meters, it is still undergoing its motion. So that means only 1/4 of the potential energy it has lost, and that has got converted into the corresponding kinetic energy. So let's read the options what they have given. Lose 1/4 of its total energy. Absolutely wrong. How can it lose its total energy? Lose 1/4 of its potential energy. Yeah, this is correct. Option B is correct. Then let's check question 42. Which of the following statements about electromagnetic waves, sound waves and water waves is or are correct? Question 42. Let's check. They exhibit reflection. That's correct. They carry energy. This is also correct. They exert pressure. This is also correct. They can travel in vacuum. No. The sound wave cannot travel in vacuum. So in my opinion, 1, 2 and 3, these three statements are correct. So first option, you go for it. 1, 2, 3. Thermal capacity of a body depends on the. So thermal capacity will depend on. So thermal capacity, what is basically a thermal capacity? Thermal capacity means the amount of energy required to raise the temperature of any object by 1 degree Celsius, that is per unit rise in temperature. That's the way. So it depends upon mass of the body. It does not depend upon the shape and size. It does not, because once we are telling that it does not depend upon shape and size, so of course volume is out of consideration. So in my opinion, mass of the body is the option correct. Then 44, a container is first filled with water and then the entire water is replaced by mercury. The mercury has a density 13.6 times the density of water, and therefore they are asking that what is y. Of course, this y is the mass of the mercury will be 13.6 times that of the mass of water. So y will be 13.6x. That means question 44, option C is correct. Y is 13.6x. Okay. Now density of water is, density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. You people need to remember this, density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. Anyway, all the best for your exam, and you do practice and repeat these questions.